Hello everyone, on behalf of Rainbowloom, this is Angelynn, formerly known as TutorialsByA here on YouTube. Today, I'm here to show you how to create this Excalibur bracelet. I am so excited about this design because I implemented an extra border technique to where we can create this on one loom. So this one here is made on one loom. I added an extension so that way it would fit my wrist. If you have two looms, you can connect them together lengthwise to create this one that goes all the way around. But even though this design looks like it's five rows wide, we will just be using the one single loom widthwise. The lengthwise connecting is just if you would like to make this full length version. We also won't be doing any transferring of any sort. This is made in one go, minus the part where we add the extension, and I'm so excited about this technique. I've been implementing it in a lot of the new designs that I've been creating, and it just makes bracelets come out so cool. So I can't wait to show you all how to do it and how to make this bracelet. So this design might look a little bit intimidating, but I want to say that upper intermediate loomers could make this as well as the advanced ones, of course. I tried my very best to explain every step super thoroughly so that way everyone could understand how to make this bracelet. There are just some new things to learn in this video just because I am teaching a technique that I haven't seen in any other bracelets before. But once you get the hang of them, they're fairly simple, and you'll also be seeing them in some upcoming videos as well. So if you want to learn how to make some of the more advanced bracelets that I'll be posting on Rainbow Loom's channel, it's definitely worth a learn. Today, I'm going to be using the Bracelet Boutique Kit. If you've seen some of the previous videos that I've made on Rainbow Loom's channel, you may have seen me mention this. It's one of my favorite kits because I love pastel colors, and as you can see, all the bands in here are pastel. It also comes with two looms, which I love for making bracelets that go all the way around your wrist, like these two here. But just in case you have one loom, today I'm going to show you how to make this one with an extension. However, if you have two, you can just connect them together like this. And then during the tutorial portion, you'll just make the design all the way down the two looms instead of a single one. And of course, if you have the original rainbow loom, which looks like this, you're welcome to use this as well. In addition to the one loom today, you'll also need a hook. I'm going to use my metal tipped hook today. This design is pretty low tension though, so if you don't have a metal tipped hook, you'll be just fine using a plastic one like this. Of course, you'll also need some sort of closure for your bracelet. Today, I'm going to use a C-clip, which looks like this, but this Bracelet Boutique comes with G-clips, which can also be used to close up your bracelet. The rubber band counts for this single loom version of this bracelet are 28 for this inner border, which is white here, and on these bracelets, it's yellow and this dark pink. In addition to these 28 bands for the border, I used 14 to create this extension. You might need more or less depending on your wrist size. For this outer border, which is blue and purple here, red here, and orange here, I used 26 bands. For the center chain, I used 12, which is this pink chain here, this red center chain here, and the light pink chain going through the center here. And for the X bands, which are these loops kind of that you see out here, and then they go inside to the center to make the X, I used 22 of those total. For my X bands on this bracelet, I alternated colors, which is what I'm going to do today with this teal and this blue color. For the two loom version of this bracelet, you'll need approximately double the amount of bands that I had mentioned for this one loom version, minus the 14 bands for the extension. Before beginning, I'm going to make sure that my loom is oriented correctly by making sure that this arrow down at the bottom here says the number 1, and my pins are in a U-shape orientation. The first rubber bands we'll place are the inner border bands, so on this bracelet they are dark pink. I'm going to place one single band first of my inner border color on this bottom center pin, and I'm simply going to drop it here at the bottom. This will help us close up our bracelet later. So now we're going to start placing the border bands. I'm going to take my first color and take a single band of this, and I'm going to place it from the bottom center pin up to the top left, like this. We'll continue making this border all the way down the left side and stop at the second to last pin here. So I'm going to go vertically here and then take one band at a time and continue making this chain going up. And now that I'm reaching the end, I'm going to stop there with the vertical bands, and then my last band for the left side will go from this pin on the left up to the top center like that. So your loom should look like this with nothing on this top left pin. And now we'll continue to do the same thing on the right side. So again, I'm taking a single band, placing it from the bottom center pin up to the right, and then we're going to make this chain going all the way to the second to last pin on the right side now. So vertically up like this, and then continue this process. Now that I'm at this last one, I'm going to go in again from the right up to the top center. And we now should have a shape like this on our loom. If you counted out your bands, you'll have one band left of this border color, and we're gonna save this for later. Next, I'm going to push all my rubber bands down. And the next layer that we'll add on is our outer border bands. And here's where the extra border technique comes in. We are going to place these next border bands, which for me on this bracelet were orange, and today for me will be pink. We're gonna place these on the same exact pins that we had just placed the white border on. I'm taking my first pink band, going from the bottom center pin up to the left, and you're basically just gonna act like the white bands aren't even there, and you're gonna place them in the same way that we did with the white. So, going vertically, and again, all the way up to the second to last pin on the left side, one rubber band at a time. And then again, when you get up here to the second to last pin, place one from the top left up to the middle, and we're gonna do the same thing on the right side. And then same thing at the very end, we're gonna go from the top right pin here up to the top center. And then nothing should be on these two up here. And this is what my loom looks like at this point. Now we're going to place our center chain, which is the one that's gonna go straight through the middle. For me on this bracelet, it was light pink, and today I'm going to be using yellow. So I'm gonna push down the bands on this bottom center pin to make room. And then I'm taking my first yellow band and placing it vertically here. And then we'll place a vertical chain going all the way down the center row of pins here. And then when we reach the end here, the last band that you'll place for this center chain is going to go on this pin here up to the top center. So your loom should look like this now. And I'm now going to push my bands down again just to make room for our last layers of bands, which are going to be the X bands. I realized my blue and teal jelly bands might be a little bit hard to see with this colored loom, so I went ahead and switched to some opaque bands of the same color from a different kit. And now we'll start with making our X bands on the loom. So on this bracelet, my X bands are multicolored. They're yellow and teal. And today I'm going to show you how I alternated colors to get the same effect, but with these two colored bands instead. If you want your X's to all be one color, you'll just use the same band color for this step instead of alternating like I am today. For this layer of bands, I'm first gonna take my first color, which is teal, and I'm going to place this from this bottom center pin up and around these four like this, so that way I get a diamond shape. With my next color, I'll do the same thing on the right, making a diamond like that. So these X bands will be placed around four pins at a time. Now for my next row, I'm going to take blue first instead of teal first like I did last time, and I'm gonna go around these four. So they are overlapping. This diamond is overlapping with the one on the bottom. And then I'll take my teal one and do the same thing on the right side, like this. And basically at the start of each row of these diamonds, I'm going to use the same first color that I did on the last color of the previous row. So since I ended with teal, I'm going to start with the teal band again and go around these next four pins. And then I'm going to take my next color, which is blue, and go around the next four. So seeing that I just used blue for the end of my last row, I'm going to use blue for my first row, like that, and then I'll do teal next, since I just used blue, like that. This is what my loom looks like at this point. Your diamonds should be overlapping like this. You don't want to leave a gap between your diamonds and make it like start here for the next one, you want to see that they're overlapping here. I'm going to continue doing these diamonds all the way down the length of my loom, and I'll show you when I get towards the end so that way you all know how to finish it off. So I'm reaching the end of my loom here, and for my last teal band, I'm gonna go like I have been before, and then this is what my last blue band looks like. And so you can see that the end of our diamonds are at the top left and top right pins here, and we still don't have anything on these two up above here. So this is where the diamonds stop, and at this point, this is what my loom looks like. And we're now ready to rotate 180 degrees. And I'm now gonna add my cap band. I'm going to add it to this bottom center pin here. If you have this plastic hook, the end of it is a cap band applicator. And to use it, I'm going to take my single band, wrap it around the bottom once, twist, and then a second time. So I have a band doubled over at the end of this hook. Now I'm going to place the end onto the pin that I want to transfer the cap band on, which now is this bottom center pin here. And I'm going to slip it down and slide it onto that pin. If you don't have this hook, I'll remove this. You can just take this one band, wrap it around this bottom center pin once, twist, and then onto it again for a doubled over band on this bottom center pin. And now it's time to start the hooking process. You should have an arrow at the bottom pointing up that says the number 2. So to start, we're first going to be hooking this yellow center chain here that I have, and at the same time, we'll be flipping over these X bands here. So first taking my hook, I'm going inside the cap band and I'm pushing these top two layers backwards, and then I'm grabbing this yellow band that's here. So the top two layers are of the cap band, and the third one is my yellow band, and I'm going to hook this up. Next, we're going to reach inside here, push these bands back with the back of your hook. Make sure you're not reaching into this little hole right here. You want to go inside of the pin here to where you can push these X bands backwards and out of the way. And then at the bottom there, you can see I have my yellow center chain band that I'm going to grab and hook this upwards. At this point, we can start to establish a pattern for hooking the center chain. So I've hooked this yellow center chain upwards. Now we're going to hook the X bands, or flip them over, I should say. We just hooked this yellow center chain band up onto this pin, and to the left of this, I have this horizontal here that's blue. You also have a horizontal band going right here that's below it, or on the bottom of it, but we're going to be dealing with this one instead. I'm going to take my hook and pull this band right here off of the pin and release. So you should have a triangle shaped band here now. And so going back to the pin that we had just hooked the center chain up onto, I'm going to the right of it now. And again, I have this one up here and then this one below. We're always going to be dealing with the one that's up here. Taking this, I'm going to grab this and flip this over the center pin as well, like that. So now we have this kind of bow tie shape with our X bands. So now we're gonna go back to the yellow center chain. So it'll be center chain and then flip over the two X bands. And then another center chain and then flip over the two X bands. So here's our center chain. I'm reaching inside here, pushing these back out of the way. Make sure you're going inside here, grabbing this center chain at the bottom, hooking this upwards. And so we just did a center chain, now it's flipping over our two X bands. So I'm going from this pin to the left, and this layer that's the one going above, this one is wrapping around this pin up here that we had just hooked this yellow one onto. If you accidentally grab this, you won't be able to flip it over this pin because it's not above it. So you want to grab this one and flip it over. Then I'm going back to this pin, grabbing this blue one here, and flipping this one over. Like that. Now for another center chain, I'm going inside this pin, pushing these bands out of the way, and then I'm grabbing this yellow center chain here, hooking it upwards, and next is our X band, so I'm going to the left of this pin, whatever one's wrapping above it, so like this, and flipping it over that top pin, and then going to the right of it and going over with the other side. Now for another center chain, I'm going inside here, pushing these out of the way, grabbing this at the bottom and hooking it upwards. Then I'm going to the left of this pin, grabbing this band, flipping it over the pin, and grabbing this right side band and flipping it over the pin, like that. Going back to the center chain, I'm hooking this yellow one up. Then I'm grabbing this blue band here to the left of it, flipping it over, and going to the right of it now and flipping this one over. Back to the center chain. And now from this pin on the left, I'm gonna grab this one, flip that over, and then to the right of the pin, flipping that one over. So I'm gonna continue this down to the rest of my loom, and I will meet you all at the end to show you what my loom looks like. So here at the end of my loom, I'm going to continue the same thing that we were doing before, hooking this last chain up. And now it should be very easy to visualize what band there is to flip over, because there's just one layer up here and then on the right. So at this point, this is what my loom looks like. And our next step for the hooking process is our outer border bands. So for me, they were orange on this bracelet. If you'll recall, earlier in the video, we added two layers of border bands. For me, I placed white all the way around these pins, and then I came back and I added a pink layer on top of that white. In today's version of the extra border technique, we'll be looming the pink bands first, also known as the second layer of border bands that we placed on. And then after that, we will do the first layer of border that we placed on, which for me is white. So we're gonna do whatever layer you have that's kind of sandwiched in the middle here first, and then we'll come back and do the very bottom layer border bands last. So taking my hook, I'm gonna start in this bottom center pin here and reach inside of the cap band, so this white band that I doubled over, and I'm gonna grab this topmost pink band, and this should be going to the left here, like that. Now we're gonna continue hooking this pink single chain all the way down to the very end of our loom here. So I'm gonna go inside of this pin, push all these layers that I don't want back, and then grab the bottom layer that's pink. So for me, it's the third to last band. And then I'll show you a side view. Reaching in here, we're grabbing the third to last band, which is the bottom pink band, and hooking it upwards to the next pin. Again, from the side, make sure you're going inside of whatever this X band color is for you. So go inside here, push this back, and then grab the pink band through here and hook it upwards. Make sure that you're not grabbing this pink band from out here. You want to go inside of this X band, push it out of the way, and then grab the pink band here and then hook it upwards. So I'm going to continue this process down to the end of my loom. And once you reach the end here, you're gonna do the same thing with this pink band, hook it over to the top center pin, like that. So at this point, this is what my loom looks like. And we're gonna do the same exact thing to the right side now. So I'm reaching inside this bottom center pin through the cap band, pushing it out of the way, and then I'm gonna grab this pink layer here, hook it over to the right. Reaching inside the top three layers here and pushing them out of the way, I'm gonna grab the fourth layer, which is the third to last band, and hook it upwards. Again, I'm making sure I'm going inside of this X band here and then grabbing the pink band from there instead of grabbing the pink band from out here. So you just wanna make sure you're going inside here. And we'll continue hooking this all the way up our loom. Again, when we reach the end, I'm gonna grab this last band here and hook it over to the top center like that. So now this is what our loom should look like. And now we're going to do another step of the extra border technique. This is kind of an unconventional step, but once you pick up on it, it's very easy to do. So what we're going to do is flip one layer of the pink bands or whatever border bands we just hooked over. So it doesn't really matter what order you do this in. I'm gonna start on the right side just because it's a little bit easier to show on camera. I'm going to skip this bottom pin for now because it's a little bit harder to visualize, so we'll come back to this pin later. I'm gonna start on this pin right here, and our goal is to flip this band over the pin like that. So I'm gonna put it back for now just so I can explain which band it is in case you couldn't catch it. So on this pin, you can see that I've got this pink V-shape right here below it. I'm going to grab the side that's towards the inside of the loom, so towards the center of the loom, which for this pin is this band on the left here. And as you can see, this pink layer is above this blue layer right here, and then there's another pink layer below. We're gonna grab the top pink layer right here, so whatever this left V is, and flip it over this pin and release. So now this is what I have on my loom, and it's as simple as that. We're just gonna go through and flip all of those over on every pin. So to show you again, I'm gonna grab whatever layer here is towards the center of our loom, and it's the top layer that's pink for me, and flip it over the pin like that. Again here, I'm grabbing it here, and you should see that there's two pink layers here, but they're sandwiching one of these X bands. So it's whatever layer of this chain is above the X band. And that makes it easy to identify how to flip it over, especially at the bottom here because they get twisted. So I'm gonna do the same thing here, flipping this over to the outside, grabbing this one here, flipping it over to the outside, and then we'll continue doing this down our loom. I grab this and I kind of pull it a little bit just to make sure that I don't accidentally grab the bottom layer of it, because if I do, I'll see that X band start to move. So if you grab the top one, you'll see the X band doesn't move. And flip it over. So again, and that's just how I check to make sure I'm grabbing the right one. So I'm continuing this down, and this is the pin where we'll do this last. So flip this one over, and do not flip the one over here over, because you're just gonna pull it off of that pin there. Now going back to the bottom of our loom, I skipped this one because it's a little bit different to visualize than the rest of these, but once you learn how to do it throughout the rest of your loom, this one becomes a little easier. So again, you wanna grab the top layer here. It's sandwiching an X band a little bit differently than the rest of the pins here. So I'm gonna look through at this X band here and make sure that I'm grabbing the top pink layer and then flipping that over. If you accidentally grab the bottom one, you'll see it gets kind of weird. So you're just gonna grab the top one. Now we'll do the same thing to the left side, and we're flipping over the inner portion of it. So earlier we were dealing with the left side of the V because it was closer to the center. This time we'll be dealing with the right side of the V shape right here because it's closer to the center. So I'm doing the right side here, grabbing the top layer and flipping it over. Same thing here, grabbing the top layer of this pink chain, flipping it over. And then I'm going to continue doing this all the way down my loom, stopping at the second to last band, because again, we don't want to pull that band off of the loom. And here is where I'll stop. We don't want to flip this over at the very top because we didn't do it to the right side earlier. So at this point, this is what my loom looks like. It doesn't look terribly different from earlier, but you should see that none of your pins on the outer border here have two layers of pink anymore. They just have this one that's below the X band. So go through and make sure that you flipped all of them over. Again, it doesn't matter what order you flip these in. You can start on the right side over here and then skip up here and do one and then go up here and do another. So if you see that you missed flipping one over, don't worry about having it be out of order. Just flip it over and your bracelet will turn out just the same. So now I'm going to push my bands down here a little bit just to make room for the last bands that we'll be hooking, which are our inner border bands. So for me, they're white, and again, this is our very first layer of border bands that we had placed earlier. So for this, we're just gonna go through and hook these all around, ignoring all the other bands on here. We're not doing anything special anymore, like flipping. So I'm going inside of my cap band, pushing this out of the way, and grabbing the second to last band and hooking it up to the left. And then I'm gonna continue hooking this single chain all the way down the left side. Reaching inside of all of these layers, make sure you're going inside the pin through all of these, pushing these back, grabbing the very bottom layer, and hooking these upwards like that. So continuing to do that. Again, make sure that you're not reaching from out here. Make sure you're going inside of the X band as well, which you can see me pushing back with the back of my hook. And then we'll go down and grab that very bottom band's hook for the inner border. So I'm going to do this down the left side, and I'll see you towards the end of my loom. So here I'm doing my very last band, reaching in here. There's not an X band to push back, so you're just going to reach in here and grab the bottom layer, pull slowly because there's some tension there, and then I hook that up to the top center. I feel like my loom is all over the place today. Okay, so now for the right side, we're going to go in here, grab this very bottom band, hook to the right, and same exact thing, hook this all the way down to the end of your loom. Now that I'm reaching the end here, we're going to do the same thing, hooking this one from the top right up to the center pin. And at this point, this is what my loom looks like. And now I'm going to rotate a little bit so that way it's horizontal like this. And we have this single loose band here that we placed at the very beginning. I'm going to kind of scooch it outwards here and grab this with my non-dominant hand. And then with my dominant hand for my hook, I'm gonna reach inside all of these layers to grab this band at the bottom. You really wanna make sure that you're going through every single layer here, otherwise you'll end up losing some of your bracelet. So if you take a couple tries to make sure, that's fine. This is what it looks like from the side. Reaching in here, pushing back all of these layers, and I'm grabbing this very bottom layer. And you want to be very slow and careful with this because there's a lot of tension on this pin. So go slow. And then I'm not gonna pull and force anything. I'm just gonna grab this end here and place it on my hook like that. As long as both of these ends are on here, you'll be good. And I'm just gonna scoot that up my hook a little and then leave it like that. And we're free to remove this entire thing off of our loom at this point. I'm gonna be fairly gentle because I don't want anything to break, but nothing on this loom is super, super high tension, so you don't have to worry too much about breaking any bands if you're being gentle. The only pin you really gotta worry about is this last one, and you can give your bracelet a little bit of a stretch to even out all of the bands. And here is the front. I love how all these X bands look, especially with the multicolored pattern. If this is not long enough to fit your wrist, you'll need an extension. Clearly, this is too small for me. So we'll set that aside for a little bit. I'm gonna start again with making an extension. My loom is oriented to where the bottom here says one with an arrow pointing up. And to make a single chain, I'm sure everyone who can make this bracelet can make a single chain. We're gonna start with a single band, start at the bottom center pin, go up to the right, and then we're gonna make a zigzag. I will add a link in the description box below if you would like to watch an in-depth tutorial on how to make a single chain. For me today, my extension's going to be 14 bands long. You might need more or less depending on your wrist size. I have a pretty small adult wrist. If you have a small wrist, you might need the same amount of bands or less. I'm gonna push these down just to make the hooking process a little bit easier. And now I'm rotating my loom 180 degrees. At the bottom here, you should have an arrow pointing up with the number 2. So now to whatever pin is the bottom of your single chain, you're gonna take this bracelet here on your hook and transfer these two layers of bands onto this pin right here. So for me, I like to insert my finger inside and then pull with my hook just to create this nice opening that I can make sure goes right onto this bottom pin and release. And I'll hold on to it while my bracelet adjusts here into the loom so that way nothing falls off. So here's my loom. I'm going to reach into this bottom pin here, wherever is the end of your single chain that your bracelet is sitting on. I'm reaching inside these top two layers here, pushing them back, and then grabbing the bottom band here, pulling this off, and then up to the top center, or the top left pin here. So just to give you another view. So again, I'm reaching in through here, through the top two layers, grabbing the bottom, hooking up to the right, inside the top two, grabbing the bottom, and we'll continue doing this all the way down our loom. So I've done my chain all the way to the end, and at this point I'm going to grab my C-clip and scoop up these two layers on this top pin, like that. So when I tug, all of the layers on this pin should be being pulled and in the C-clip, and if they are, you are safe to remove this from your loom. So I'm going to take my C-clip on this end and attach it to the cap band on this end, which should be the same color as your inner border, which is white for me. So here it is. I'm gonna grab that with my C-clip. There we go. We've completed our Excalibur bracelet. Thank you all so much for watching this tutorial on how to create the Excalibur bracelet. I'm really, really excited about this extra border technique. I've been applying it to a bunch of different designs and have been coming up with some really cool bracelets, so I can't wait to share them with you all on this channel. If you haven't subscribed already, be sure to subscribe and hit the notifications bell so that way you can receive notifications every time we upload a new video. Currently, I've been posting a new tutorial every Thursday at around 2 to 3 p.m. Central Time. In the description box below, you can find our social media accounts linked. We post a lot of creations, so our account is great to go to if you need some inspiration on what to make. We also share photos that you've posted to the hashtag rainbowloom, and we also love to be tagged in them at this username, just to make sure we don't miss anyone's post. All the supplies I use to make these bracelets can be found at rainbowloom.com or at our partner retailers. I really hope you enjoyed learning how to make the Excalibur bracelet. Thanks so much for watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you next time on Rainbow Loom's channel. Bye!